chucked up a Allen wrench in the tool post, and that's going to be used to rest my knife used to shape the radius on the tip. And I use a Tina blade, and it's specially made for cutting leather and shaping tips. And it's a surgical steel blade, and I keep it really sharp. And all we do, gives me a lot more control when using a single edge razor blade or something a lot of guys will use. I like to have a better grip on it. If you don't know what you're doing, this can be dangerous. Gonna hit this, knock that sharp edge off of the now we're going to hit it with some 800 grit, just briefly. don't want to cause any friction heat that could soften the epoxy. 1,000 grit. 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 And finally 2,000. That polishes up the barrel good also. Finally, we got a couple other steps that we do. I use a Tiger liquid burnisher. It's for leather and Q-tips, and it helps to seal the pores of the leather on the edge. I know some guys will use spit to do this step, but this is made for this application. I don't really want somebody spitting on my cue. That's just being lazy. It might work, but I don't want it. This piece of leather, just hold it on there briefly and it creates enough friction heat to seal that. I like to use this because it lets the layers of the leather on laminated tips shine through. Some guys are using darn magic marker, black or brown. Would you rather have a wax base burnisher, or would you rather have spit? That's done now. They're getting a super shaft clean with it. So we gotta change out the tool post and put the shaft in the lathe for that application, for that job. We'll be back.